So welcome again to this particular session. And last time when we finished up, we finished 2.7. In fact, 2.7, I asked you to do it by yourself. And we are now picking up 2.8, and it's pretty interesting question. Not very tough, but at the same time, especially if you are in the know of all the nitty and gritty. So Link Limited, in this question, Link Limited is the company and it is having a head office in Bangalore. And very important line, opened a branch. So the branch is newly opened branch. That been on 1st of January, they have opened a branch, and branch is at Mysore. If it is a case of new branch, there cannot be any question of opening balance of stock or opening debtors, etc. Now question says that where all sales were on credit basis. The question has very specifically given that all the sales are on credit basis. That means there are no cash sales in this question. Further, it is given that goods are supplied at 20% above cost. Goods are supplied at 20% above cost means if your cost price plus margin is equal to invoice price. That means if your cost is 100, your margin is 20, because rate is based upon cost. I will consider cost as the base, and your invoice price will be 120. So 20 by 120 or 1 by 6 will be your rate of loading on invoice price. At the same time, you will have to compute the rate on cost, which will be equal to 1 by 5. Correct? I told you that now onwards, it is your bounded duty to compute what we call rates, not only on invoice price, but also on your cost price. During the year ended 31st of December 2023, the following transactions took place. Goods sent to Mysore at cost 22,000. Now see here, it is very clearly given, goods sent to Mysore at cost to head office. Now at cost to head office means these goods are at cost price. So these goods are at cost price, you will have to convert them into invoice price by adding the rate of profit on cost. Returns to head office at cost to head office. So again, goods which have been returned are at cost. Is it clear to you? Sales as shown by branch. Now these are all credit sales. Cash received from debtors and remitted to Bangalore will find place only in debtors account, because in this system we do not have a common account like branch account. Debtors balance written off. So these are bad debts actually, which you are going to write off first towards the credit side of debtors account, and then you will also write them off by debiting them to profit or loss account. Further, it is given loss of goods at branch through theft is estimated at 1% of the goods received. First of all, you need to know actually how much goods this year head office must have sent to branch. For that, you will have to compute the invoice price of these goods, because branch will receive the goods at invoice price. So whatever goods branch received, 1% of that will be treated as abnormal loss. And you know the treatment of abnormal loss. Abnormal loss will be first of all put towards the credit side of the branch stock account. Then loading will be taken to the debit side of branch adjustment account. And finally, abnormal loss at cost will be taken to the debit side of profit and loss account. Further, it is given that stock of goods held by branch on 31st of December amounted to 5820 at invoice price. Now, closing stock is given to you at 5820. It is at invoice price. So this is the question. I don't think you will confront any difficulty in this particular question, but still I will solve it for you. So this is question number 2.8. I will prepare branch stock account. This is the major account. Branch stock account, and don't let it skip out of your memory that branch stock account is always prepared at invoice price. So this is my branch stock account. I think this much is enough. And then I will prepare branch adjustment account. Branch adjustment account. branch adjustment account, wherein we are going to incorporate all the what we call loadings. Besides that, in this question, I will have to prepare branch P&L account. So branch P&L account also. This is my branch P&L account. And then finally, I will have to prepare, just wait. I will have to prepare branch debtors account in this question because credit sales have been given to us. Branch debtors account also. Branch debtors account, correct? So now we can move. The first item which is given to us is goods sent to Mysore at cost. Of course, in the branch stock account, I am going to write here. In this question, there cannot be any possibility of opening stock because it's a newly opened branch. So first of all, I am going to write here opening stock. Sorry, I told you in this question, no need to write opening stock because it's a newly opened branch. So I will start with goods sent to branch account. Goods sent to branch account. Now goods sent to branch account at cost is given to us 22,000. So at cost, I will write here 22,000. I will have to bring it to invoice price. For the same, I will use the rate of profit on cost, which is 1/5 and which is equal to 4,400, I think so. So 4,400 will be 1/5 of 22,000. So that means the invoice price is 26,400 of these goods. Is it clear to you? So now we can say in the current year, head office must have sent 26,000 worth of goods to the branch at invoice price. Of course, we will take the loading of this one. We will move over to the credit side of branch adjustment account, load on goods sent to branch. If you want to show, you can write here 26,400 into 1/6 now, because it is at invoice price. In order to extract the loading, you will have to apply the rate of loading on invoice price. Of course, your loading amount will be equal to 4,400. Then next item we have got, in this case, goods returned by branch to head office. So towards the opposite side of branch stock account, I will write goods sent to branch account, returns. Again, it is given at cost. So I will write here 840. This is the cost price. I will have to convert it into invoice price. I will apply the rate 1/5. And it is equal to 168. 168. So 1008 will become the invoice price of goods return. Correct? And then finally, I will take the loading of this item to the debit of branch adjustment account. Load on goods sent to branch returns 1008 into 1/6. That is equal to 168. The next item is sales. I told you sales are all on credit basis. So I will write here sales. Of course, these are credit sales. 19,670, because these are credit sales, I will have to incorporate them in the branch debtors account also. Credit sales, 19,670. And then we have got, in this case, cash receipt from debtors, that is 15,190. By cash, you can simply write by cash, because this is debtors account, it automatically means cash from debtors. 15,190 worth of cash we have received. In this method, that is stock and data system, cash receipt from debtors will find place only in debtors account. I told you, because we are not having any common account in this case, as we had in the earlier method. Debtors balance written off as bad debts. So some of the debtors you might be feeling that will not pay to you now. So you have written them off as bad debts. 640. Because you are preparing P&L account also, bad debts will also find place in the P&L. Don't let it escape out of your memory. Bad debts 640. Loss of goods at branch is estimated at 1% of the goods received. This is important line. This is what exactly I was telling you at that time. Because you have sent 26,400 worth of goods. Branch must have received these goods. So 1% of this will be considered as abnormal loss. So you will write here abnormal loss. That is 26,400 into 1%. So 1% of this will be equal to 264. Now, as far as abnormal loss is concerned, we will write the loading towards the debit side of branch adjustment account. Abnormal loss, loading on abnormal loss, 264 into 1 by 6. That is equal to 44. Now, abnormal loss at cost price will also be presented in the branch profit or loss account, isn't it or not? So, abnormal loss 264, that is invoice price, minus loading. So abnormal loss at cost price will be equal to 220, which you are going to present in the P&L. Then finally, in this question, we have got closing stock, and closing stock is given at invoice price 5820. So I will write here balance carried down 5820. We will take the loading of closing stock also. Loading on closing stock 5820 into 1 by 6. 5820 into 1 by 6, how much it is? 970. So 970 is the loading. Now all I have to do is to just balance this account. If I am going to balance this account, my credit side is bigger. That means I am balancing figure is arriving towards the what we call debit side. If balancing figure and the balancing figure is 362, what should I construe this figure? Should I construe it as surplus opening stock or goods sent to branch? I told you the first preference is given to opening stock. Now opening stock is not given in the question because an opening stock is not possible in this question because it's a newly opened branch. Second preference is given to goods sent to branch. Now goods sent to branch is already given in the question. So we are left off with no other alternative than to treat it as surplus. So this is your surplus balancing figure. So many times I have told you now, surplus is not broken into loaded part and cost part. Full amount of surplus is taken to the branch adjustment account. So you will write here surplus 362. Now you will derive your gross profit. Gross profit as per your solution is 2720. So 2720 should be your gross profit. Let me see. 362, 168, 44, and 970. It's okay. Now, gross profit will be transported to the credit side, 2720. And then finally, we will get the net profit. Net profit, in fact, this gross profit, actually, I'm having a bit of confusion. Let me check it. I think there is some misprint, so let me check it. 4,400 plus 362 minus 168 minus 44 minus 970. It is 3580. So your gross profit is 3580 actually. And then you will write the gross profit towards this side. And then you will subtract 640 minus 220. 2720 is your net profit. 2720 is your net profit. This is how you are going to solve this question. Correct? So cannot be considered as a tough question, but and finally, you can also tally your branch debtors account in this question. However, from branch debtors account, you will get closing balance, but it will be of no use under this particular method. 19,670 minus 15,190 and minus 640, that is 3840. This is closing balance. That's all. Because in this method, we are not preparing branch accounts separately. Correct? So now we move over to 2.9. Let's see actually what is in this particular question. Says, White Line of City X has a branch at City Y, and in order to maintain a strict control on stocks, invoices goods to the branch at selling price, which is cost plus 33 1/3%. I have solved this type of equation so many times. Your rate will be 1/3 on cost and 1/4 on selling price. Again, I will solve it once. Don't worry about it. First, let me actually solve it. Rates analysis. Cost price plus margin is equal to invoice price. First you write, rate of profit is given on cost, consider cost as 100, margin will be equal to 1/3 and invoice price will be equal to 133 1/3. Correct? Now you take 33 1/3 in the numerator. In the denominator, you write 133 1/3. This is your invoice price. Similarly, because we have to compute rate of profit on cost also, so I will write 33 1/3 in the numerator, and in the denominator, I will write 100. Is it clear? And you can also write it this way. Correct? 100/1. Now, if I will solve it, it will be equal to 100/3. And if I will solve this one, it will be equal to 400/3. So many times I have solved. Correct? Similarly, if you will solve this one, it will be equal to 100/3 and below 100/1. So you can see here, two zeros are cancelled, three cancelled. Similarly here, two zeros are cancelled. Are you getting my point or not? Actually, what I am left up with in this particular question? Here I am left up with 1/4. So rate of loading is 1/4 on invoice price. And here I am left up with 1/3 in the numerator. And in the denominator, I am left up with 1/1. If I will solve it, it will be equal to 1/3 into 1/1. So ultimately, it will be equal to 1/3. So rate of profit on cost will be equal to 1/3. And on invoice price, it will be equal to 1/4. Is it clear to you? This should not give you any trouble. However, in this question, I don't think I will need the rate of profit on cost because it seems everything is on invoice price. Let's move. Given to you opening stock at invoice price. So opening stock is given at invoice price, debtors Opening debtors, you will write in the debtors account, goods sent to branch during the year is at invoice price, no problem. Cash and credit sales, both you are going to write towards the credit side of branch stock account. Cash receipt from debtors, only in debtors account. Bad debts in debtors account and P&L account. Discount in debtors account and P&L account. And expenses will be written in P&L account. And closing stock is 13,400. So logically, question should not be a big problem for you. Correct? Now, in this question, see here. First of all, we have been given opening stock. So towards the debit side of branch stock account, I will write 15,000 opening balance, or I can write opening stock also. I will take the loading. I will write here towards the credit side of branch adjustment account. That is load on opening stock 15,000 into 1/4 3750. I have taken the loading now. Next item is opening debtors. Opening debtors will be written only in debtors account. In the debtors account, I will write balance brought now. Goods sent to branch during the year. Towards the debit side of branch stock account, I will write goods sent to branch account. Correct? 67,000. And then I will take the loading. I will write here loading on goods sent to branch account. 67,000 into 1/4. 16,750. Then next item is cash and credit sales. Cash and credit sales, cash sales and credit sales. First of all, you will write coolly towards the credit side because both type of sales are written here. However, you are preparing debtors account also. In the debtors account towards the debit side, write credit sales. Correct? Cash received from debtors will be written in debtors account. I will show you debtors account also. Opening balance is there. Credit sales is there. Cash receipt from debtors I have just written. Then next item we have in this case is bad debts written off and discount. Both these items will be written first of all in the debtors account, discount and bad debts. And we will also put these items on the debit side of branch profit and loss account. This is your profit and loss account. So discount and bad debts will also find place over here. Then we have expenses at branch. You can simply debit it to profit and loss account. Closing stock is given. You will write closing stock 13,400. And you will also take the loading. You will write here loading on closing stock 13,400. Correct? 13,400 into 1/4 3350. Now, I will start telling branch stock account. In this question, my debit side is more. So I'm getting balancing figure this side and the balancing figure is 200. The first preference is given to closing stock, but closing stock is already over there. So now we are left off with no other alternative than to treat it as deficiency. So we will treat this item, this balancing figure as our balancing figure, and this balancing figure is can be termed as deficiency or shortage or spoilage. I have already told you, actually, this deficiency, shortage or spoilage is nothing, but it is also considered as a sort of abnormal loss. So what you are going to do now, I have already told you the treatment about the abnormal loss so many times. So first of all, you will take the loading of this shortage or spoilage or deficiency. So load on shortage. 200 is the amount of deficiency, 1/4, 50 rupees you have written over here. Then in the branch profit and loss account, you will write shortage at cost. 200 is the invoice price, 50 is the loading. So 150 at cost, you will debit it to profit and loss account. Then you will tally your branch adjustment account. From there, you will get what we call gross profit. You will take this gross profit to the credit side of branch P&L account. And then you will tally this one, you will get 9,700. When you will prepare your debtors account, you will get balancing figure 8250. This 8250 is nothing but closing balance of debtor. However, in this method, closing balance of debtor is not going to play very significant role because we are not having any common account in this particular what we call method. Now we pick up question number 2.10. Let's see whether it is manageable or I need to do it for you. In this question, City F head office supplied goods to branch at City H in Uttaranchal at an invoice price which is cost plus 50%. Your first target should be to compute the what we call rates. When I will compute the rates in this case, when I will compute the rates, as usual, I will write cost price, margin, and I am going to write invoice price. Cost is 100, margin is 50. So invoice price will obviously be 150. So rate of profit on invoice price will be 50 by 150, that is 1 by 3. And rate of profit on cost will be 50 by 100, that is 1 by 2. However, in this question, I don't think there is any item at cost so far, what I feel, but I exactly do not know. Further, it is given that cost plus 50%, and further, all cash received by the branch is remitted to Delhi. And all branch expenses are paid by head office. These are normal general things. From the following particulars, you are required to prepare branch stock, branch adjustment account, and of course, branch profit and loss account. These are the things which you are supposed to prepare. Opening stock is given. You can easily manage it. Opening data is given. Petty cash balance is given. In this question, if petty cash is given under this system, it is always better to prepare a petty cash account. I will do this question for you, don't worry. Goods receipt from head office is given 1,86,000. In this question, there is no goods in transit. If there would have been goods in transit, first of all, you would have added goods in transit to it, and then you would have written to the debit side of branch stock account as goods sent to branch account. However, in this question, no goods in transit is there, so we can simply write goods sent to branch 1,86,000. Goods returned are 3,000. Credit sales are 84,000. Further, in this question, we have been given allowances to customer of selling price. See, allowances to customer of selling price already adjusted while invoicing. Allowances to customer, I told you, is treated as a sort of normal loss. And I have already told you, as far as normal loss is concerned, first you are going to write full amount to the credit side of branch stock and then full amount to the debit side of branch adjustment account. Cash receipt from debtors is given, and these are the expenses, rent. Actually, it is cash sent for rent, salaries, and petty expenses. Then we have got cash sales, closing stock, and petty cash closing balances also given in this particular question. So let me solve it for you. First of all, I will write here branch stock account. Then I will write here branch adjustment account. And then branch P&L account. I think this much is enough. And then finally, I will write branch debtors account. Branch debtors account, correct? So, if you want me to, if you will give me some time, let me put up the lines. Putting up lines is a big problem. Give me just one more minute. I know it creates a bit of botheration, but just to have a neat presentation. See here, this is the problem. And finally, traders account also. So this part actually requires lots of patience. Anyway, now we can start with the question and the solution. So in this question, opening stock is given. So I will write here opening stock. Nothing is written. So I will presume the opening stock at invoice price. If nothing is written, we always presume stock at invoice price. Towards the credit side, I will write load or opening stock 60,000 into 1 by 3. That is equal to 20,000. This is how you will have to move. Then we have been given branch status 12,000. I will simply write balance brought down 12,000. Branch status 12,000. Then we have been given in this particular question petty cash balance. I told you in this system, if petty cash balance is given, it is better to prepare a petty cash account. Correct? It is better to prepare a petty cash account. So this is your petty cash account under this system, and I will write the balance brought down over here. Petty cash balance I think was 100, so I will simply put it to the debit side of petty cash account, 100, and then goods received from head office. See, in this case goods received is given, correct? So I will write here goods sent to branch, because here we have to write goods sent to branch account. What I am trying to tell you is that in this question, goods received is given 1,86,000. Suppose if in this question there would have been any goods in transit, I would have had added to goods received to know the amount of goods sent to branch account. However, in this question, we can directly write 1,86,000 because no goods in transit is given. Is it clear to you? 1,86,000. Then I will take the loading. Goods sent to branch 1,86,000 into 1 by 3. So what will be the loading? 1,86,000 divided by 3, that is 62,000. 62,000 will be your loading. Then in this question we have been given goods returned to head office 3,000. So goods returned 3,000 is given to us. So first of all, I will write towards the credit side of branch stock account, goods sent to branch returns 3,000. Then I will take the loading and I will write towards the debit side to load on goods sent to branch returns. Amount is 3,000 into 1 by 6. That is equal to 500. Correct? And then in 2.10, we have been given credit sales. Credit sales are given to us is equal to 84,000. So credit sales and cash sales, both type of sales find place towards the credit side of branch stock account. credit sales 84,000. Because we are preparing debtors account also, so credit sales will also be written in the debtors account, isn't it or not? So I will write here credit sales 84,000. Then in this question we have been given, after credit sales, allowances to customer of selling price. It is a sort of bargaining which is done by the customer, so we have to reduce the what we call selling price. So it is considered as normal policy, it is considered as normal loss. So that is why I will write normal loss. You can write in bracket allowances to customer. Allowances to customers of selling price. Allowances to customer of selling price is 2000. Because it is a normal loss, full amount of normal loss will be put towards the debit side. Of branch adjustment account. We need not require to actually split it off. Is it clear to you? Allowances to customer of selling price is considered as normal loss. Pay attention. However, sometime question may give you like this, allowances to customers. Sometime question may give you just this way, allowances to customer. If question gives you in this manner, allowances to customer, then it is treated as a sort of discount and it will be written in debtors account, that is credit side, and then it will also be written to the debit side of profit and loss account. Then it is not treated as normal loss. Allowances to customer. However, if it is written allowances to customer of selling price, then it is treated as normal loss and treatment will be like this. Clear? And then cash receipt from debtors is given. Now, in this method, cash receipt from debtors, which is actually how much? 2,400 only, will be written in the debtors account. Cash receipt from debt customers. We will write 2,400. And then we have been given in this case, head office has sent cash for rent. In the branch P&L account, I will write rent. So expenses rent, how much was the rent? Rent is 2,400. Then head office has sent cash for salaries. You will write here two salaries. Amount of salary is 24. And see here, head office has also sent you petty cash for 1,000. Now, because we are preparing petty cash account, in the petty cash account, first I will write two cash. Because head office has sent further cash. And further petty cash is 1,000. So I am going to write here 1,000. So total petty cash available with the branch manager at this moment is 1,100. Then we have in this case cash sales. Cash sales 1,04,000. I am going to write here cash sales. 1,04,000. 1,04,000 is the amount of cash sales. And finally in this question, we have, not finally, but first closing stock. I will write closing stock 54,000. Balance carried down. 54,000. This is closing stock. And you will take the loading of closing stock. In this question, actually, rate is 1 by 3. And here I have taken 1 by 6. Extremely sorry. So this item must be equal to 1000. And 54,000 divided by 3 will be equal to 18,000. Correct? So, closing stock loading we have written, and last item we have got now, petty cash. Now see here, petty cash balance you will have to write over here. First of all, balance carried down. Actually, if you remember, under data system you used to write opening balance to the debit side of branch account, then whatever cash was sent by head office to the branch used to be written towards the debit side of branch account, and closing balance used to be written to the credit side. But in this system, actually, what we see, out of 1100 closing balance is 100 only. It means 1000 rupees must have been spent. So your petty expenses actually is 1000, because out of 1100 closing balance is 100. So 1000 we must have spent on petty expenses. So this balancing figure will be taken to profit and loss account, and it means petty cash is spent, or simply petty expenses. Is it clear to you? So I will write in the branch profit and loss account, petty expenses, actual petty expenses we write here, 1000. Now we can tally this. If I will tally this one, the balancing figure I am getting only 1000, and it will be treated as surplus. Because opening stock is available, goods sent to branch is available. And this surplus will be taken to the credit side of branch adjustment account. Surplus 1000 you are going to write. Then you will compute your gross profit, and according to them, your gross profit must be equal to 62,000. You please tally it of your own. Then this gross profit will be taken to the branch P&L account, 62,000. And then finally, you will be able to get your net profit. And your net profit will be 34,600. Yes, it is 34,600. Then you will prepare your branch debtors account, and balance carried down you will get as the balancing figure 93,600. In this method, branch debtors account's relevancy is not much there. Correct? However, if in a particular question credit sales are not given, in that case branch debtors' relevancy will increase, because credit sales find place in the branch stock account also. So this is the point here. So 2.10 was not tough. 2.11. You can do this question again by yourself. Rates are similar to the last question, cost plus 50%. Actually, these are two questions given to you simultaneously, you can say. One is related to Kolkata branch, another is related to Chennai branch. Suppose you are preparing Kolkata branch account. First, you prepare Kolkata branch, then Kolkata branch adjustment account, then Kolkata branch P&L account and debtors account. Now, opening stock is given at invoice price, no problem. One third loading you can easily compute. Your rate on loading will be equal to one third. Opening debtors, you can write it in the debtors accounts. Goods invoice to branch at cost is given. This time at cost price is given. So you will have to convert it to what we call invoice price. How will you convert? See, 34,000 is the cost price, and your rate of loading on cost is equal to 1/2. So you will add 17,000 to it. So its invoice price will be equal to 51,000. Correct? Its invoice price will be equal to 51,000. Cash sales is given, credit sales is given. No problem. Cash collected from debtors is also given. Cash collected from debtors is written in the debtors account only. Goods returned by debtors, you have to exercise caution in this method. Goods returned by debtors, first you are going to write to the credit side of debtors account and also to the debit side of branch stock account. because sales return always are written against the or corresponding to the credit sales. So that is the reason. Then goods returned to branch by head office. Now this time head office branch has returned goods to head office. It is simply a case of goods sent to branch returns. Now this is the line which would need attention. Goods transferred from Chennai to Kolkata branch. Chennai branch has transferred goods to Kolkata branch. See here, you are having two branches. One is Kolkata and one is Chennai. And you are preparing Kolkata branch account. And Chennai branch has transferred goods to you. That means you have received the goods. So goods transferred can come towards the credit side of branch stock account and also to the debit side of branch stock account, depending upon the fact whether you are receiving the goods or you are transferring the goods. This time you are receiving the goods. So 2100, you are going to write goods transferred, write in bracket received, and then write it to the debit side of the branch stock account. Correct? Then nothing is given here. Shortage of goods is given. Sometimes shortage of goods is already given in the question. You know, first of all, you write it to the credit side of the branch stock account. It is a sort of what we call abnormal loss. Take the loading to the debit side of the branch adjustment account. And of course, shortage at cost to the debit side of branch P&L account. Discount to customers will find place towards the credit side of branch account and then to the debit side of P&L account. Expenses at branch in the P&L account. When you will tally this account, what you will get? You will get closing balance as the balancing figure. Correct? Closing balance as the balancing figure. You must have noticed here. This is actually, I have prepared both the accounts simultaneously. First, you pay attention only towards the Kolkata. See, I have written 9,300 as the opening stock and I have taken its loading in the branch adjustment account, 3,100. Correct? One third of 9,300. Goods sent to branch at cost plus margin. I've already told you, cost is how much? 34. Margin 1 by 2, that is 17,000. It will be 51,000. Because now it is at 51,000, you will take the loading. Load on goods sent to branch. Actually, I have done in the solution, I have taken net figure of that. But what you do of your own, when you will prepare the branch adjustment account, you simply take the loading of 51,000 and you will apply the rate of one third, your loading will be 17,000. Or you want me to solve this question? I will solve it for you, no problem at all. But I will do it for you in the upcoming session, correct? Because we have a limit set to it. We cannot exceed that. So that's the reason actually I have to stop the class here. We cannot move it beyond what we call 60 or 70 minutes. And 60 minutes are coming to an end. So I have to end it. I will take this particular session in the next one. Correct? I will solve it for you. Till up to 2.10 you need to do. And that's the main point. Okay, then shall meet you in the next session.